Hello and thanks for tuning in. I'm Holly Shields. Welcome you to another edition of Kalkine TV's Executive Corner Expert Talks. Today we're fortunate enough to be hearing business insights from special guests of the Mexican Chamber of Commerce in Hong Kong, also known as Mexcham, which is the first Latin American business association in the region. Yamilette Cano is the founder of LOUDER Global and the head of communications at Mexcham, and Susana Munoz serves as president of the organization. Welcome to the show, Yamilette and Susana. Thanks very much for joining us.
Hi, hello, Holly. Nice to see you here.
It's a pleasure to have you on the show. Thanks very much for your time. First and foremost, I'd love to know, how does Mexcham help in promoting business, commercial, and investment opportunities in Mexico, Hong Kong, and mainland China?
Well, Mexcham is the first Latin American business association in the city. We definitely want to help to bring more awareness of the business opportunities that there are between Mexico, Hong Kong, and mainland China. And we want to help companies build these opportunities. These past few years, we have seen many changes in the international trade and investment flows. You know, China-US trade war, Ukraine war, COVID. And all these events have created painful disruptions in their supply chains. So over the next few years, we're gonna see China losing its attractiveness as a manufacturing center, but the country still accumulates lots of technology and know-how for this industry. So Mexico definitely will benefit from bringing more investment in the manufacturing industry, the know-how and the technology that China can bring. As for Hong Kong, which is a financial center developing its own tech industry and located in the middle of the Greater Bay Area region, we see many opportunities for Mexican companies developing clean technologies and fintech projects using the city as a platform to dip their toes into the Greater China market. So our agenda as a chamber is mostly focused on promoting these sectors with Mexican and Chinese companies through webinars, events, and specialized publications, among other events that we do or not day to day.
Well, that's great to hear, I must say. It sounds like there's plenty of room for growth there in both regions and plenty of collaborative opportunities there too.
Yes, there is. There is no doubt COVID brought a lot of challenges for businesses and governments around the world, but it also brought many opportunities and new technologies and changing the way that we do business. So in our area of expertise, which is international trade, we have seen many developments such as online trade shows, online investment roadshows, e-commerce that help facilitate this trade and investment flows between both sides of the world. So one of the main effects of the pandemic, as you know, is that business travel in Asia has been reduced. So we see now more entrepreneurs and companies adopting these new technologies as the new way of doing business. So I am convinced that associations like ours, Chambers of Commerce, are very key now in helping companies identify these opportunities in new markets and help them tap into these businesses. So I think we're going to have pretty busy years ahead as a Chamber of Commerce.
That's great to hear. It sounds like you have a very crucial role as well in the works there among all these businesses, and I think really putting that collaboration to work and helping the business community there in Hong Kong.
Yeah, there is. We are really happy to help these companies in identifying these business opportunities. We're really happy to promote events to help facilitate more businesses and more opportunities between countries which are so far away, such as China and Mexico. Yeah.
That's a great goal to have, I must say. And I'd love to hear from both of you as well, particularly some business advice now. What would you say are some of the crucial things that companies can do to create a winning customer base? Because we know that is quite a challenge for many enterprises.
Well, I would say that one of the first things to do is to be transparent, to communicate, and to go to the instances that can help you, like the Mexcham or any other instances from organizations from your country that would be able to direct you to the right journey, to the right people, to connect, network, and not be afraid that despite we are perhaps at the other side of the world, that we can still build those connections. We can create those collaborations.
Right, that sounds like it's a really important thing. You put emphasis there on networking, and I think it's probably something that especially maybe startups and new businesses really heavily rely on, especially in foreign countries even. I think that must be a really crucial thing.
It is, because a lot of people, when they venture outside of their country, they believe that they must be there. And perhaps before, because it was easier to travel, we could connect with people face to face. But now with the global openness of online connectivity, and we have all these platforms, it's easy, it's still easy to connect with other people. And in Hong Kong especially, I would say that organizations or corporations are very open for these relationships. In Hong Kong, we have one government instance that it's called Invest Hong Kong that helps a lot the startups and to put their companies in the right direction. We also have Cyberport and the Science Park. So there's many organizations and corporations that are able to assist you throughout the whole journey.
It's great to hear. It sounds like you have a really thriving business community there.
Indeed, we have.
Yes. That's excellent. And I'd love to know as well, speaking of communication there, in your opinion, what are some of the key criteria of effective communication from a business perspective to a larger audience?
As I said before, first of all, we have to be transparent. We have to constantly communicate what is the company doing, what are the steps, how are we able to help them. Very important. And constant communication. Before, perhaps, if we didn't have the solution or we didn't have the product 100% or the service, we would decide to wait until everything will be done. But nowadays, our customers are expecting for us to constantly communicate with them. If any regulations change, for example, us in the chamber, we are constantly communicating with our members. If regulations change, if they need to look out for anything in the supply chain, or if there's any extra taxes that they have to look for. So constant communication, I will say, is one of the first things, and that transparency, so we can build the trust and be honest with our clients, and they can also understand that they could be honest with us depending on their requirements and requests.
Absolutely. You're quite right there. I think transparency is really crucial between businesses and clients, but also I think from business to business activity and in that network as well. So very important. And now just before we wrap up, I'd love to hear about your objectives for LOUDER Global and for Mexcham for the rest of 2022.
Susana, do you want to start? Yeah,
well, definitely for the Mexcham, we were going to focus the next months into promoting trade, investment, and more communication between the manufacturing, fintech, and clean technologies sectors. We continually have events in which we promote these opportunities. We talk to government authorities, to specialized agencies such as Yamilette just mentioned in Invest Hong Kong, and to different chambers of commerce in Mexico who can help us bring together these business communities from both sides of the world and the South China region.
That'd be great to see. We definitely look forward to that. And for LOUDER Global?
Thank you, Holly. For LOUDER Global, continue participating, having these relationships and connections with the chamber and with other organizations, as Susana said, but also not be afraid of utilizing these platforms to have our message come across. So people can know that they can rely on us and we can rely on them if it's required. So utilizing the software, again, being open and communicating with potential clients and our existing clients more.
Well, very important there. We definitely look forward to seeing that from LOUDER Global and for both organizations to, I think, capitalize on and take advantage of all this growth opportunity in the region. So we'll definitely keep our eye out there. But with that said, thanks very much for joining us on the show. If you just joined us, that was Susana Munoz, the president of the Mexican Chamber of Commerce in Hong Kong, and Yamilette Cano, the head of communications. Thanks very much for joining us today.